Hello everyone, Arun Van Gopal of WNYC here. It's my pleasure to introduce the Center for Traditional Music and Dance's series, Beat of the Boroughs, NYC Online. This online series features over 50 of New York's leading traditional instrumentalists, dancers, singers, poets, and more. From Mongolia to Haiti, Colombia to the Gambia, among many others, they remind us how the strength of our country lies in its embrace of diversity and immigration. We want to celebrate these remarkable members of the New York community in these challenging times. So please enjoy these 50 programs, share them with your friends, and spread the word. Enjoy the show.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Zafir, and I just did a taksim on an instrument. The name of this instrument is the nay, and it's made out of bamboo, as you see. And have 9 sections of bamboo, and have 6 holes on the front and 1 hole on the back. And this thing is the mouthpiece. And the nai is an instrument that played in the Middle East, in Syria, Egypt, some parts of Africa, North Africa, Morocco, Jordan, and it's one of the oldest instrument in English. You could call it an inblown flute, and this is the nay. And now I'm going to talk
with you. Instrument?
Yeah, should I show them that one, Sammy?
Yeah, sounds good. This is Zafir Tawil. Oh yeah, you mentioned that, didn't you?
Yeah, I said my name.
Zafir is one of the most fantastic Arab musicians in New York. Plays every single instrument, and it was fantastic to be able to bring him to this Flurry Festival. So thanks to everyone in the Flurry Festival.
Thank you, everyone, for making this happen. Should I do a taksim first, and then I'll talk about that with the same? This was an oud taksim, a weird one on Nawa Athar, going to Rust, coming back to Nawa Athar. These are the name of the scales that I just played, or the maqams. This is the oud. It's made out of wood, and I pluck it with a pick made out of animal horn. And the oud, it's, as you see, it's a half pear shape. And we call this the face, and we call this the tasi. It means in Arabic the bowl, because this looks like a bowl, you know, the soup. And the oud is the forerunner of the guitar and the lute. And it's fretless. That way we can play microtones. Yeah.
Nice. So with our group Zikrayat, we do music from Egypt and Syria and around the Arab world, but especially Egypt and Syria. So since we're going to have some Egyptian music and belly dance in a few minutes, I thought it would be nice if Zafar sang some qudud, which are light songs from Syria. Sound good, Zafar?
Yeah, sounds good.
Something is coming through on this.
Can we mute the chat, please? Can everybody mute their chat?
ولا بتغير ولا بتحول
يا عيني اعطيني بؤس دخيل الله حالي حالي مالي مالي حالي حالي حال مالي مالي ايوه حالي حالي حال مالي مالي مال حالي حالي حال مالي مالي مال قلبي تلوع يا وعدي بدي طبيب داويني قلبي تلوع يا وعدي بدي طبيب داويني دوا الطبيب ما بينفعني دوا الطبيب ما بينفعني شوفت حبيبي بتشفيني يا عيوني شوفت حبيبي بتشفيني
Shukran.
We did some Qudud from Haleb, light songs from Aleppo, in Maqam Rust and Maqam Hijaz. We're about to bring on a belly dancer for you. For a moment, I'll talk about my instrument and then about what we're about to see. So I'm playing the violin. The violin has been a part of Arabic music for over 150 years. And has been one of the main instruments in Arabic music starting from the beginning of the 20th century. Like the oud, which was the ancestor of the European lute, the violin actually is descended from string instruments from the Middle East, the rababa, which became the rebec when taken to Europe by the troubadours, was the ancestor of the viol family. So in the early 20th century, late 19th century, when the violin was brought back to the Middle East by Europeans, it eventually replaced the indigenous stringed instruments in the urban ensembles, and that's a lot of the music we play. I tune my violin a little differently. I tune G, D, G, C, a lot like the oud. So we're going to do a belly dance set for you, and belly dance is based, rooted in also in indigenous dance traditions from the Middle East, and we focus a lot on Egypt, and the name there is Raqs Sharqi, which means Eastern dance, and we're going to do two numbers for you, one a very rare dance piece from We're starting with that one, right? Naima?
Yeah.
A rare dance piece featuring the famous dancer Naima Akif, who starred in Egyptian movies in the mid-20th century. And then we're going to do a very famous belly dance piece that served as an introduction to an Umm Kulthum song. So these are great Egyptian pieces of music, and we're going to have one of the best belly dancers in New York with us today. I have to say, this is my first live performance in months. And I'm really honored to be here with Mr. Zafar Tawil, who is playing his third instrument of the day, probably not his last, and with Maria, one of the best dancers that you'll ever get to see. So please welcome Maria, and thank you all very much for watching. Thank you. Maria, everybody. Give a big hand for Maria. All the way from Brooklyn, New York. Mr. Zafar Tawil, also from Brooklyn, New York. I'm Sammy Abu Shamez from Queens.
Shukran.